and shit, y'all. What up, though? Your boy Judy is in Detroit City. It's so weird, man. I'm still not used to this shit. Just white people walking all over me. I'm white, too. But, yeah, there's just white people walking all over. Me and my special lady friend. Like, you and, like, this, it's unheard of. Like, 30 years ago, back in the day, when I was, like, a teenager, I walked from Gratiot all the way over to fucking Cass and Selden. And, like, was walking through alleys and didn't get harassed by one bum. It was fucking... It's really weird, man. Cats out here, they just move in. It's odd, cause I think a lot of cats. Anybody that's in a place that's been gentrified or has just changed over the years, like, you picture it a certain way. I'm like, even when we was gonna walk down Cass, I'm like, hey, let's walk a couple blocks north before we hit Cass, cause there's still some fucking crackhead liquor stores over here that we need to avoid. And then you got people that's not from here and they don't even understand. Like, you're like, you don't even understand. Like, you couldn't even be on this block fucking back in the day. It was Night of the Living Dead. It was fucking Night of the Living Dead with dope fiends and shit. And I had a delicious... We ate a delicious meal at She-Wolf. With Anthony, it was Anthony Lombardo, the cat that came in and taught cats how to make pasta. What did you learn from that? If you're listening, what did you learn from that, guys, ladies? When you make your pasta, you take some of the water that you're boiling and you put it back in with your sauce because there's starch in it. Shout out to Chef Mark, too. They sent us a bunch of fucking food. We grubbed, threw down. Shit's been good out here in Detroit. I like it. Cannabis Cup is coming up. As a matter of fact, what's the, where's it at? Did y'all pull it up for me?
Yeah, stand by. Hang on a second.
That's for one fucking thing at a time.
Russell Industrial?
At Cannabis Cup, Russell Industrial, Saturday and Sunday. I'm going to be there Saturday. And we're giving away tickets. Two tickets. If you're in the Detroit area and you're 21 years and older, yeah, and you want to come and check out the Cannabis Cup, I'll be there. I'll be at the Wish thing, slanging my little hyena tree. All the Wish weed is good, but I'll be at the Wish shit. I think the old boys Cash Out will be there with me too. Call up right now. I don't need to talk to you or nothing like that, but call up. I'm giving away tickets for the rest of the week.
How many tickets are we giving away today?
Just one pair.
Okay.
And then later on, there's an after party too, that we'll be giving away tickets at before the news. Are you calling me?
Negative.
Why are motherfuckers calling me right now? Yeah, let me see that shit. Let me see the fucking after party. We'll be giving away the after party shit at 3, I believe. 6 your time. At the Penthouse Club on 8 Mile. Oh, that's a titty bar. Hosted by Wish Premium and by Lug Entertainment. That's Boss Your Life Up, gang. And I might stop in there and say hello. Starts at 10 p.m. on Saturday. You can look at my fucking story if you want to get a table. They got a number there. I don't like getting tables. I'm not shitting on the whole table idea, but like, if you want to get a table, look on my story to get a table. sidebar shit, I feel like tables really ruined club life. Like when I was young, like you just had to be cool to be able to get in the club. And then it was like money came in and like they'd let any fucking douchebag, as long as they fucking bought a $400 bottle of goddamn Grey Goose, come into the fucking spot. And then they got the fucking sparklers and shit. But if you want to see some real Detroit fucking make it rain type shit, come on out to the penthouse thing. I gotta fly out in the morning. I might just stop in for a lap dance. I was over on the west side today. I was driving all around. I was on the west side today. I drove by La Chambre. That's where I used to get the old hand jobs.
Where, in the back?
They had a fucking, you go in there, you pay to get in, and there's a bar, and you walk past this room, and there's a room off to the left when you're walking in, and it's just like, it's a square room with benches. You fucking throw, and the girls got fucking, they got lotion, and they got the fucking, what's the shit that killed the disinfectant shit that they got the lotion and the disinfectant. So it'll fucking jerk you off, clean you up, clean off your hands.
What did it smell like?
The lotion?
Oh no, I mean it's like
cheap ass jergen shit, that cheap ass fucking jerk off lotion.
But it didn't smell of cum around there. Weird stains on the floor or anything?
It wasn't like, yo, it's, John's asking a real ass question. Like, if you ever go to a fucking, if anybody knows and they've gone to like a peep show and you step in those booths, it is a cummy, it smells like fuck. It is a cummy smelling.
I remember I nearly slipped and caught myself. Like,
this was like when I was doing Jenny Jones, man, this is like pre-internet shit. And like you, and like if you wanted to jerk off, like it's $15 to get a goddamn movie, you know what I mean? And like Jenny Jones wasn't paying for that shit, so there was some porn shop on Dearborn I'd go over to, and you'd go in there and they had like a television, you would hit buttons and it would scroll through movies and it'd be like every fucking type of movie you could imagine. Like the most disgusting shit, fucking white, black, fucking, and trannies, gay, like fucking just everything. So you just typing through it and it fucking, and you're in like this little ass box and it just smells like fucking cum. And you just get your shit off and get the fuck going. Those were the days. I still would get pussy and shit after the show, but sometimes you just gotta go catch a nut real quick. Call up right now if you can relate. 888-742-3345. So the last time I went to La Chambre, I stopped going cause I'm trying to get this girl to fucking jerk me off, and she's like, I can't do it. I'm like, girl, why are you scared? She's like, cause my mama here. And I look over and her mama was giving a lap dance right next to me. Can you imagine that shit? Like you and your mom just working side by side, fucking giving out lap dances on fucking Telegraph in 96. That kill yourself shit. I looked over, sure enough, I was like, damn, that is your mom. Some fucking 40-year-old lady grinding out some dude. I was a cunt hair away from stopping in La Chambre to get a fucking hand job today. But I had chores to do. John, you were supposed to remind me of the fucking we're gonna start a I can't see if anyone's calling, by the way.
Yeah, we're working on it.
Well, I need a bit more. I need a bit more communication on your side.
Understood. Okay? So, but you were talking about that lady is coming around again.
Yeah, the girl that fucked the dog.
Whitney.
Whitney.
Whitney, Wisconsin.
I got, look, John's bad at communicating with me. He's really bad at that shit.
That is your position.
Dude, you're awful at communication.
I don't think that's true, but okay.
To work in communication, you're awful at it.
False, but okay. I talk to you all the time. I talk to you all the time. I tell you what you need to know. I could get better, but...
Did anybody call since I've been talking?
I've got,
Yeah, of course. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. I've been talking for fucking 10, 15 minutes.
You want to know the truth? I'll give you the fucking truth. Fucking truth. So,
give me the truth.
The truth is this. So there were calls blowing up, and then I've got a couple people here. They're answering the phone calls now. There was nobody related to that one topic. I've got one guy here. We've got Mark in Chicago.
All right.
And Chris is going to help me out with that. Boom.
Yo, Mark, what up?
Yo. What up, bro? Hey, so what you're talking about is Hubbard and State. And right in that area now, they changed it to the headquarters for the police station. It's all touristed out now.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's right where I'm at.
Yes.
Yeah. It's
yeah, man. So peace out. That's all I want to tell you.
All right, man. I'll be up here all week if someone wants to pop their head in. There it is. Thank you. That had nothing to do with the jerking off thing, John.
Well, that's what the note said. I can talk to the person who spoke to that person. I mean, I've got Kyle in New Jersey.
Whatever, dude. Anyway, so we're trying to get fucking Whitney, Wisconsin to... We're trying to bring Whitney, Wisconsin to California. This is the woman that John booked. Fucking John, I gotta tell you, you're a gem. You're a fucking gem. John was able to book this chick. Shut up, John. Let me finish. John was able to book this fucking chick in jail, collect call for fucking dogs. And I think she's out.
Yeah, she just got out.
She just got out.
And we got her in some trouble with that. She even indicates that in these messages to me.
She got in trouble for talking about fucking dogs?
Yeah. The calls are monitored, and she's there talking about bestiality, so...
Wasn't that what she was locked up for anyway?
My memory of this is that she was locked up, and I'll have to go back and talk to her again, but I think it was something to do with she was filming porn in public, and then somebody
with the
who...
dog. Well, or she was drinking pee, too.
That you can find on YouTube in like 20 seconds.
We gotta have her come in, man. We're gonna set up a fucking we're setting up a goddamn GoFundMe. What's it gonna cost? Like probably like a G, right?
I mean, I guess the flight and then
flight in a hotel room, a
couple nights, fly around in Spirit or something.
Yeah, Spirit, John.
All right, fine. Just trying to keep the budget.
Look, it ain't our money. It's the fucking it's the listeners. If they wanna hear from the girl that fucks dogs, and they want us to talk to her and bring her in and have her do fucking crazy shit, they'll kick in a couple bucks, and we'll fly her ass out. And if not, then we won't fly her out. It's on them. That way we don't have to ask. We don't have to ask the bosses for permission. We just do what we do. Crowdfunding, man. Crowdfunding. Go straight to the crowd. The crowd dictates what they want. You know what the worst part is?
What?
Part of me kind of wants to smash her because she's so disgusting.
She really is.
Dude, she is so disgusting. Part of me just wants to beat. What does that mean? Like, I want to smash some chick that fucks dogs and drinks her own pee. Like, it's fucking crazy. I really need to go to a therapist or some shit. We got a Satanist coming. We got a Satanist calling up. If you guys want to talk to him. And if that doesn't go well, we got Slang vs. John, and we got Black, White, or Other. You can win yourself some the Promescent dick spray. Bam. or some lube. And in the news today, we have a brand new sex position, John, I can't wait to hear about. If you're black and you have to take a test for cocaine use, I think you need to stick around and listen to this because we got some shit to lay on you. Do not go anywhere. It's an all-out show with your boy Judy in Detroit at the Foundation Hotel. I'm here all week. Come on by. Pop your head in. You want me to sign some shit? I think tomorrow I'm gonna have them give me some weed. I'm just gonna give out weed to people that come by. Cause I'm fucking cool like that. I'm here for fucking Dream Cruising. I'll be at the Dream Cruise and the Cannabis Cup. If you see a cat, holler at me. We'll snap a picture. Detroit what, bitch? Let's go.
It's time for the All Out Show Remix. On Remix shows, you'll hear memorable guests, crazy topics, game shows, celebrity interviews, and you might even catch a hilarious segment you missed. Keep it here and stay tuned.
Security cameras caught a white orb wandering around the gym.
There was a 8 to 10 foot hairy man looking person.
If you noticed strange lights in the sky over the weekend, you aren't alone.
It's time for news from the fringe on the All Out Show.
Shade 45, we have Lucien Greaves. He is a Satanist. Welcome to the show.
Good to be here. Thank you.
Is there a difference between a Satanist and a devil worshiper?
There is. Satanists are generally non-theistic. They don't believe in a literal personal Satan, but Satan's a metaphor for rebellion against tyranny and religious authority.
So y'all just... You guys are basically like trolls.
How do you mean?
Like, you pick Satan... You could have picked some other shit that wouldn't trigger people.
We grew up in a Judeo-Christian society, so these symbols mean something to us. We couldn't just pick something else and say that this is meaningful to us. This is the kind of artistic raw material of our environment.
Okay. All right. That's fair enough. Why not like just be like pick Thor or some shit like that?
Because there again, we're not. At least I'm not Scandinavian. I mean, okay. Some people in Scandinavia do gravitate towards Satanism or whatever else. But it's not like we're from the outside coming in and saying, "Hey, it's funny to mess with Christians." A lot of us grew up in a Christian environment and found that kind of cultural programming that we endured very oppressive. So the idea of the revolt against tyranny and against religious theocracy, especially in the United States, when we have this kind of conservative right movement attaching itself to the cross and trying to undermine gay rights, trying to undermine people's ability to get abortion, the idea of Satan kind of being the focal point for our symbolism for rejecting that kind of religious authority, that kind of encroachment of theocracy, it makes sense in the context of Satan in the way it wouldn't make sense to us in the context of Thor or any other type of metaphorical deity.
Are like are pro-choicers stoked that Satanists have their support?
Well, at first, a lot of people weren't. You know, a lot of people who had previously been involved in some of these causes we're championing now weren't happy about it, but we're making a unique argument, and some people have come around to see a real value in that, because religion confers people with certain privileges and exemptions that other people just don't have.
So like
when
what?
We start making, like, when you start asking for exemption from certain laws, you generally don't do that on just the grounds of conscientious objection. You have a much stronger argument if you say this is with your religious tenets, which a lot of our arguments always are. They're attached to some pre-existing tenets and beliefs that we have. And then we're able to take these things to court and litigate and say, like some of these restrictions against abortion, restrictions against multiple voices in the public square, where they're allowing, you know, religious voices to put forward their message. We have an argument that some of the other advocates for these causes just don't.
So right now in the world, just out of curiosity, you were saying Judeo-Christian, there's Jewish Christianity and Islam that's coming out of there. What do you think worldwide are you the most concerned about?
Well, worldwide, we're just concerned about the encroachment of theocracy overall. I mean, you do see...
But which theocracy do you think is most oppressive?
Well, I don't really know. It's not really a competition, but we're primarily U.S.-based, so we can only do what we can inside the law, inside the United States. We're not in a position right now to really start up chapters in, say, the Middle East or whatever, and we might not want to, because we work within the system, and we don't advocate for violent reform, and we don't want to start chapters in places where it might get people killed or anything like that. So, by necessity right now, just...
You just answered my question. That's enough said. You just answered my question in a roundabout way. I guess I don't know what I believe in, but I do think it's crazy that religious churches and stuff, they don't have to pay taxes. Are you exempt from paying taxes as well?
Yeah, we just got that exemption.
Congratulations.
Well, thank you.
Would you rather that all religions pay taxes, or are you happy to have an exemption?
Actually, I really do think they should all pay their taxes. And at first, we weren't going to apply to be tax exempt because we were trying to send that message that we think the churches should pay their taxes, they shouldn't be tax exempt. But the point where Donald Trump said he was going to repeal the Johnson Amendment, and the Johnson Amendment is what prevents churches that are tax exempt from engaging in politics, we realized that we'd be just at a disadvantage from our opposition. We're already outnumbered. We're already outfinanced. So we decided to take the leap and get our tax exemption, get our recognition too. And there was another benefit to that, in that it prevents us from being in court and having to argue again and again that we're a legitimate religion, because the IRS is the only federal agency that has anything to determine whether anything's a real religion or not. And they found it in favor. Yeah.
And can you explain that one thing? I didn't quite understand that. What Donald Trump wanted to take away?
It was the Johnson Amendment. The Johnson Amendment said that if you're religious tax exempt, you cannot also involve in politics. You can't endorse candidates. You can't be involved directly in politics in that way. You can't help finance candidates or anything like that.
Oh, and old boy wanted to fucking get rid of that shit? I don't agree with that. That's bullshit.
Oh, yeah, no, he's definitely pandering to the theocrats, the evangelical theocrats. He has I don't think he's a real believer himself, to the credit of believers, I guess.
That guy's a New Yorker. He was probably getting tons of fucking blowjobs and shit back in the 80s from whores.
Recently, evangelicals got pissed off because he uses the Lord's name in vain too often. They don't care about his violations of human rights. They don't care about his pussy grabbing. They don't care that he was divorced several times. They don't give a shit about anything. But he said God damn it a few times, and now they're pissed.
It's funny how people pick and choose what to be upset about. I don't think they're the only group of people that are living in cognitive dissonance. You wanted to put up a statue of Satan, and you got some blowback on it?
Well, the statue is of this image. It's called Baphomet. It's this goat-headed, human-bodied creature. A lot of people just call it Satan because they don't know what else to call it.
Word.
But we were putting it at the... We wanted to put it on the Capitol grounds where they put up a Ten Commandments monument. And so our message was that the government can't pick and choose which religions are worthy of expression on the public grounds and which aren't. We have a separation of church and state. So if they were going to accept a private donation of a Ten Commandments monument, they also need to accept a private donation of our monument. And this is in Arkansas. They turned down our monument offer. And they just flagrantly said it was because we're us, you know, because yeah. they're trying to bring the gospel into the public square. And here's the thing, like, we're always trying to be very clear that we have our own affirmative values. We don't mind that people believe what they believe. We just don't feel it's the place of the government to take ownership of that and to dictate that to anybody. So if they're going to take one, they're going to have to deal with the other. And they just told us no, so we're in the middle of litigation with them right now. But that should be a resolved by the end of this year. And I really feel strongly that we're going to win that case. And either the Ten Commandments Monument will have to come down or our monument will have to go up.
888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. This is just speculation and stuff. Do you think that guy that supposedly... Who was the Jewish guy that was fucking all the kids, allegedly fucking all the kids, and had the Lolita thing, and he
the whole Epstein thing.
Yeah, he fucking allegedly killed himself somehow. Do you think he was tied to not what you were doing? Yours sounds more like a thought experiment, almost in a way, in a way to push back. Do you think he was involved in the occult? Are you aware of the occult in higher up places in politics and rich people?
No, I heard that stuff about Bohemian Grove, and you look at it, it's like a burner festival. You know, you go to any of these burner festivals, they light something on fire at the end, and there's like, it seems like this kind of ritualized thing, but everybody does these kinds of ritualized things. We all go to weddings. We all have these occasions or whatever. I don't think that's necessarily any adherence to a cult. And I don't think any kind of mystical practice or occult ideology is going to turn you into a pedophile. I think these people are pedophiles, and they needed necessarily some kind of belief system to go off and be a pervert.
Yeah, I agree with you. That just added a little razzle. I think it might have added a little razzle dazzle for some of them cats. Some people just like to fuck kids.
I think for individually, for people who are into that kind of thing can help, like, build their justification within their cognizance, right? But I don't think he's going to read some books on the occult and be like, you know what, I'm into kids now.
Yeah, true that. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. I remember we've had a Satanist. I had a Satanist on, probably about 2 or 3 years ago. And he got a fair amount of blowback. Are you finding that you're getting more and more accepted or more and more blowback?
Well, I think we're more accepted now than ever before. We've done a good job of letting people know where we're actually coming from, and we just had a documentary come out about us that's streaming now on Amazon Prime and going to be streaming soon on Hulu. It's called Hail Satan with a question mark at the end, and it shows the legal battles we're going through, and it shows the kind of community we've built and the positive things that we're doing. And I think people see us in contrast right now to the assholes in the Trump administration who are using Christianity to try to justify some of the most crass behaviors you could ever imagine coming from public officials. And I think it's helping people understand what Satanism can mean to people who are who feel that they need to act in opposition to that kind of movement, especially within the government. So I think it's really a ripe time for
You keep bringing up Trump, but to me this seems like a chorus throughout the years with government.
Yeah, but the theocrats, I think, have really gained a hold. The evangelicals have never been more deeply tied in with the government. Even under George W. Bush, I think he was a real true believer. but he didn't fill his cabinet as much, I feel, okay. which is Trump. He's put in Betsy DeVos. He's put in, like, he's put in a real prayer council, you know, and it's
okay. You know more than me. I don't know these guys. I was just, yeah. Here's the other thing. To me, I find that people, whether you call it whatever you want to call it, people find religion no matter what. Like, it's in us to find religion, whether you call it Christianity, fucking Alcoholics Anonymous, Satanism. Like, they want something to believe in. They want community. They want reasons for shitty things happening. Do you think it's just in us to look for something to believe in? And, like,
oh, yeah.
Is it? It's almost like the Christianity, Islam, Judaism, Hinduism is the devil you know. Are you concerned about the devil you don't know if we get away from these things?
I think the devil we know is bad enough that we should take the leap and get away from it. But that being said, you know, look at, like, the Unitarians. They consider themselves Christian, and they're really kind of the polar opposite of the evangelicals we take offense at and try to fight back against. So it's just kind of a difference of what kind of symbolism really resonates with you. For some people, like me, you know, the more noble story is the one in which you look away from that kind of dogmatic conditioning, and you think out, you know, and you figure things out with your own devices and come to your own moral conclusions and things. Christians can kind of find a perspective within their mythology to see it the same way. But I just think at the end of the day, people should try to judge people by their real world actions and by what they actually believe, rather than some kind of prejudice they have about what kind of belief somebody they feel somebody's obligated to hold to based on what they believe about those symbols. These things are just too big now in our culture, and they're going to mean different things to different people.
It's funny you say. I'm like more worried about, like, college people trying to shut down the First Amendment, and, like, that's their little religion, you know. Like,
I'm glad to about that, because I think too many people are too accepting of that kind of that mode of thinking right now. A lot of people are really becoming more and more accepting of limitations on free speech without really thinking of what that will mean. And I've been telling people for a while, because people look at us as these kinds of liberal gladiators now against the suppressive alt-right movement, and I think they're right. But they're also trying to shut down free speech in ways that I tell them that I think the Satanic Temple would be immediate collateral damage if you don't think this through. Because every time we do anything, we have groups of Christians claiming that what we're doing is hate speech against them.
Yeah, the First Amendment's there to protect the minority voice, basically, or the voice that people don't agree with, a la the Satanic voice.
Right. Right.
Speaking of which, do we have any calls? 888-742-3345.
Yep, we got Jay in the Bay Area.
Go ahead, Jay in the Bay.
Hey, what's going on? Yo, what's wrong with this motherfucker? He's talking about building a fucking statue of Baphomet? What you're playing with? Like, dog, like, you want some whole-ass other shit, and you're trying to lead everybody astray. Like, it's so fucking disrespectful, man. Like, for real, dog. Like, I'm on my own fucking business, but I couldn't even hold my tongue.
You're on your own.
Is going
okay to put up a monument that says "Thou shalt have no gods before me"? You think it's okay for the government to say this is the religion you have to follow? And I'm
the
one being
fucking religion we choose, because we're God's chosen people. And we don't fucking back turn our face on God to go praise Satan.
So you think it's okay for your public officials to choose your religion for you because that's the religion you already chose?
It's not about our public officials. It's about what I chose and what I was born into and what I was brought up to believe right.
I'm not trying to...
And you're so...
This church, putting it on the public grounds.
Do we got anybody else? He basically said it was what he was born into and was chosen for him, so...
All right, let's go to Tina in Stockton.
Tina in Stockton. Shout out to Stockton, by the way.
Hi, good afternoon. Praise Satan, and thank you for being on the show.
Whoa.
I just wanted to tell you that my husband and I have raised our children in pagan traditions and also in atheistic traditions, but we've just realized as of now that we're leaning, as we get older, more towards Satanic traditions. And I wanted to thank you for bringing this topic up.
Let me stop you right there. Like, what's a big Satanic tradition? Like, for, because that shit, like, me as a, I don't really believe in anything, but you was like, praise Satan, it kind of fucked me up. So, like, what is a Satanic belief in your head?
Believe in yourself. Don't give praise to anybody else except for yourself.
So, but then why praise Satan?
Because it's not the mystical, all-being, all-knowing, paranormal type of guy in the sky. Okay. Satan was just like you and I. Satan wanted to bring attention to the woes and the facts that people were having trouble on Earth.
And Lucifer Satan means, bringer of Lucifer. Light?
Yes.
Which is a little...
So, jump in.
What would you like to say?
We have this all-knowing, paranormal, bearded guy in the sky, and we have this horned, hoofed guy in the center of the Earth, but then everybody else is on top of the Earth fighting for what's right and what's wrong. But can't we just believe in ourselves? Can't we just believe in what's actually going on here and actually believe in ourselves and what we're doing?
I'm all for that shit. I don't know if I'd call it a Satanism, but like if that's what that means to you, then I'm not mad. I know it's gonna sound dumb, but like, do you like sacrifice shit or anything like that?
Oh no, I don't have time for that anyway. If I did, there's a difference between the Church of Satan and the temple, Satanic temple. The Church of Satan believes in the paranormal stuff, the hoofed guy.
Okay.
The temple believes in you.
That's
you
the kid
are
fuckers.
You.
Okay.
There's a difference.
All right, let's go to another call. 888-742-3. Lucy, I didn't think you were going to have anybody on your side, bro. You fucking surprised. I just got surprised by that shit.
I like that. Thank you.
Lucien Greaves, he's got some shit dropping on Hulu and Netflix called Hail Satan with a question mark, and he's making us question freedom of religion and what religion you want to be and what validates your religion and all those types of deals. Is that a fair way to say it?
That's a fair way to say it.
All right, 888-742-3345.
All right, we're going to go to Javier in the LBC.
Go ahead, Javier. We got West Coast over here.
Hey, what's up, Jude?
Go ahead, Javier.
Rapping West Coast. What's up, Lucy and Rude? Hey, what's up, everybody? Just a quick question, man. It's fucking confusing me a little bit. I don't want to use any words because he's coming kind of respectful, so I'm going to return the favor. And I just want to fucking know, where do you come with an idea, Satan was created by God. So why would you like worship or praise or look up to second instead of second to none? You know, Satan was created.
Humanity created by God. Don't have any respect for anything that was created by God. What are you telling me?
So do you actually believe in God, and do you actually believe in Satan, or is Satan just a symbol that you use to reject Christianity, Judaism, and Islam, and other shit?
No, God was invented by humans, and it's a myth. It's a story. The Bible is poor literature, honestly, and I feel that the better story is the story of Satan. The story that. That drives you to seek knowledge and be the author of your own fate.
All right. So Satanism, do you feel that if you like took away all that shit, like, would you call like businessmen and rappers Satanists? Were they?
Well, I don't call anybody a Satanist unless they call themselves a Satanist. You know.
Well, they can be. Do you see people behaving like what you think is a Satanist?
Oh yeah, we have very humanistic values, and a lot of people, I think, who don't subscribe to supernatural theories kind of converge on common elements of what the best moral values are, and I don't think ours are way out of bounds. And I really think it takes a lot of time, superstitious belief, to take people way out of bounds of what common moral thinking really should be.
Well, there you go. I really appreciate you. Is there anybody who want to cuss them out or anything before we go? Because I people have been pretty fucking civil.
Yeah, well, fuck Donald Trump and fuck Senator Rapert in Arkansas, too. He's the one who put up the Ten Commandments monument.
All right.
We got Matthew in New Jersey if you want to go to him.
All right, Matthew's going to cuss you out briefly.
What's up, man? Second time caller, bro.
Go ahead.
Second time caller, you put me on the air. Love your guys' show. It's great. Now, these Satanists, you guys are crazy. It's totally insane crazy that you actually believe the nonsense that you say. Yeah. I mean, how you have no faith in God and that God is legit is beyond me. I mean, he's blatantly there everywhere.
How do we believe that there isn't a bearded guy in the sky telling us what
to
think?
The horned devil under the ground? I mean, come on, that's ridiculous.
You didn't catch the fire, did you, where I said this is metaphorical and non-theistic? Listen to the fucking segment next time.
Yeah, I do listen to it, asshole. I listen to it. I listen to it every single day. I listen this way every day, but I'm a citizen 100.
Okay, try to increase your comprehension next time, then.
I really appreciate you calling up and explaining your point of view, where you're coming from, and keep up what you feel is a good fight, and help us protect the First Amendment, too, because I think it's coming from both sides. I'm seeing shit coming from both sides, bro.
Yeah, I hear you. Thank you. Thank you so much for having me on.
All right, man. Be well. All right, that was we talked to a Satanist. He doesn't actually believe in the devil shit. I want to talk to, can we get somebody to actually like cut shit up and like, I want to talk to them.
I'll find somebody doing weird shit with chickens or something.
Yeah, I want some, there was some like weird like blood lady that was like, they would have parties with those fucking child fuckers.
I don't really go that deep, but child fuckers, what?
Yeah. Right. We don't need to talk to the child fuckers, but like there was some lady that like she has like weird blood parties. She's cool with all of the fucking politicians.
I'll find her.
It's fucking bananas. Wow. So we talked to a Satanist. That was fucking. So just so we can be clear, I don't think the guy really believes in that shit. He's just doing that to fucking push back against religion.
I would agree with that. That seems to be what's going on.
Is that basically what was going on?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you guys for calling up and cussing him out, because that is entertaining to me, whether it's whether you're right or you're wrong. We all love a good cussing out here on the All Out Show. Let's play some music and come on back with something a little bit lighter.
It's time for the All Out Show Remix. On Remix Shows, you'll hear memorable guests, crazy topics, game shows, celebrity interviews, and you might even catch a hilarious segment you missed. Keep it here and stay tuned.
Hey, motherfucker, want to play a game? Hey, want to play a game? Was that Chucky? Want to play a game? No, that was a... What scary movie did they ask to play a game? Was that Saw? That little fuck jigsaw looking motherfucker? That was a creepy. And then they got to saw their arm off.
It's terrible. Did you actually watch that?
Spoiler alert. No, I don't like fucking scary movies, man. It's dark enough in my fucking head. I tried to watch that shit. It was that, and then the Hostel came out. It was all that horror, like the weird horrorcore shit.
That's terrible.
Man, fucking Hostel, like, I'm coming down off of ecstasy, and they chop the guy's Achilles tendon, and I'm like, it's really bumming me out, man. I just took a nap, and I did more ecstasy that night. I was like, fuck this shit. New and shout out to New York. That was good living. My drug dealer did so good that he was able to retire. You don't see that much. God bless that dude. Would show up with a fucking metal briefcase and a menu. And then if you ordered enough drugs, you got to roll a 20-sided dice, and if you hit your number, you get $20 worth of free drugs. What a champ. Anyway, yeah. So he had the fire E press pills and the powder. How did I get there? Oh, because I was talking about you want to play a game. We can't give you any ecstasy, but what we can give you is some dick spray from Promescent that will help you fuck longer. Oh, I'm trying to get what?
I finally got those Four Loko masturbators.
Oh, we got some Four Loko masturbators, yeah. Too, if you want to fuck a Four Loko thing.
A fleshlight. And someone suggested, hey, I guess you could do it in public then. It's designed like a Four Loko, and then you could actually start jerking yourself off with your fleshlight. At the park bench or something.
You're weird, man.
No, sorry.
You're a fucking weirdo.
Carry on.
You're gonna take one of the four local fleshlights, aren't you? You already did, didn't you?
I think we got five.
Yes
initially.
Or no, John? Did you take one?
One may have.
You're a fucking creep.
I had to test it out.
Dude, you're such. Well, how was it?
It delivered. Very very cummy.
Where did you clean it? Where'd you clean it out at?
In the sink.
In the bathroom sink.
Yeah.
It's depressing. I know, dude. It's so depressing. That's why I don't do that shit. I don't do that shit because yeah. you're fucking. If you ever really think about it, man, the sink is grimy as hell. You're sitting there brushing your teeth and spitting in it, but like, you know how many times I've washed period blood off my dick in the sink? Fucking a lot, man. A fucking lot. Because I'm a fucking Viking, dude. I'm a sav. Let's play a game. Black, white, or other. You can win some dick spray. You can win a fleshlight. You can win a... And I'll tell you, if you do win the fucking fleshlight, they got the Promescent, has the lube. We'll throw in the lube. So you can either bang your girl or... We don't have any... We need to get some dildos for the ladies. Aren't we cool with a bunch of these dildo companies?
Yeah, we can get a gross of those.
Easy. Yeah, let's get some fucking dildos. Shit, I want a dildo to, like, throw on some girls. And since I see different girls, I can't keep breaking out the same dildo, you know what I mean? They're like, where was this at? It's cool, I put it in the dishwasher. Like, they're not into that shit.
That hadn't occurred to me, but that's true. I'll bet that's true.
When the two young dancer girls were there the other day, last few weeks ago.
Right.
The Polish one and the Puerto Rican and Polish.
Right.
Like, I had a... Remember we had the fucking... What was it? The chakra dildos. They were like made out of fucking... They were made out of like amethyst, and they're supposed to be healing dildos.
Oh, right. Those gemstone ones, right.
Yeah, yeah. I think we got one left. Anyway, like, I tried that out on a chick. And I went to go show it to him, and I forgot I didn't clean it off, and it was like just like pussy juice was on it. So I was like trying to buff it off before I showed it to him.
Nice.
They're like, "What are you rinsing it off?" I was like, "No." They're like, "I was in somebody." But you know what? The girl still fucked me like a champ, like a goddamn champ. So shout out to you, little Polish lady. I'm not gonna say her name, but good pussy and a good attitude. And her friend just sat on the fucking porch. Laid out in the sun while we smashed.
That is a scene.
That was fucking, yeah. Cool as hell. That's a ride or die chick. She didn't take any of my shit or nothing. Give me a black, white, or other.
All right, I've got...
So we can show these people how to do it.
There was a woman who claimed that the meth found in her vagina...
Come on, man.
I know, but I just like the vagina, and she said...
Dude. She said meth.
And she said, hey, that's not my meth. And it was in her vagina.
It's a white person, man.
Oh, I'll give you a different one. But I mean,
For fuck's sake, right, John, meth?
But it was great because this lady, she actually stole $5,000 from a man she'd been staying with for about a week. She put that $5,000 in her pussy as well, along with the meth.
Dude, all these men, like these... This is not, like, these whores are always throwing, like, watches and shit up their pussies, man. They'll fuck a dude and take their stuff and put them, just, the pussy's like a pocketbook for a lot of these women. It's like, it's an extra pocket. They just throw it up at their pussy.
How does it stay there? Do you have to squeeze it?
I don't know. I have a pussy. I don't know how that shit works. I imagine, like, once you get it, like, once, I'm guessing, like, you know how the hole is kind of tight, and then it, like, opens up a little bit once you get it, like, once you get it up in there, it probably just, like, kind of stays, unless you push it out. I'm guessing.
All right, so.
I don't have a pussy. But I know people, like, when you hear about people that, like, smuggle shit in their asshole, you know.
Oh, that would just get flushed right out of me. I don't think I could really keep that in there.
Why, you got a big asshole, John?
No, I'm just, it just seems like I'd have to control
it. Shit's blew out?
Yeah. Just
fucking your assholes blew out from all this fucking getting banged out by the dog?
It's a gaping void. No, it's
Jesus
it's
Christ.
Tight. It's tight.
It's a fucking white lady, by the way.
Yeah.
It's a white.
Yeah,
how are you going to give me a meth one, man?
Fine. But can I give you another quick one?
Yeah, give me a different one. Give me all one right. That's, like, challenging.
Okay. So there's a guy, and he slapped a pregnant lady for smoking a cigarette. And, of course, he was picked up.
A guy slapped a pregnant lady for smoking a cigarette. I'm thinking a black guy. I'm thinking, when you just said smacked a pregnant lady, I was like, that's a brother. And I don't know why.
Wow, check this out. And then,
but then he didn't like cigarettes. That could be anybody.
So at some point, he plucked a cigarette out of her mouth, threw it on the floor, and then slapped her in the mouth.
Was it his kid?
Let's see. Since I... that is hard to see.
Because he might be like, hey, what are you doing with the fucking... You're smoking... You're making my kid smoke.
Right.
He took the bull by the horns. Fuck, it could be any... could be a white guy, you know what I mean?
He really went after her. It looked like she had a bloody swollen lip.
Oh, yeah.
And he refused to speak to police.
Didn't talk to the cops, black guy.
Oh! Damn.
Black guy.
Damn it. I don't know. Oh, yeah. Damn it.
Fuck, I'm good at this shit.
Why did I...
I'm good. I already claimed black guy, but then when you said didn't talk to the cops, I was like, black guy. You
gave it away.
I just had to keep going. Damn it.
You know, if it was a Mexican guy, I love her so much. I told her not to she keeps smoking a fucking cigarette. I come home. I was working on my fucking... No white guy, you know? Fuck, man. I fucking told her, man. Come home. She smoked fucking all the Marlboro Reds, man. What the fuck, bro? Do you want Kyle to have asthma? Do you want fucking Kyle to have asthma? Do you think you have what it takes to win Black, White, or Other? Call up right now. 888-742-3345. It's Black, White, or Other is coming up next.
Ain't that a bitch?
Overcoming racial stereotypes, one story at a time. The All Out Show presents Black, White, or Other.
Black, White, or Other, call up right now if you want to play. We got 5 headlines in the news. I'm going to read them to you, and then based on the shit that they're doing, you got to guess whether the person is black, white, or other. Other would be Latin, Jamaican, Russian, fucking Indian, shit like that. 3 out of 5 wins you a pocket pussy, and from a 4 Loko pocket pussy with Promescent lube, or just the Promescent dick spray if you got a special lady friend that you want to just bang out. It'll put some extra time on the old dickaroony. Who am I playing with today?
You got Roy in Tyler, Texas.
Roy, what up though?
What it do, Judah?
Shit, chillin', man. What do you do when you're listening to Shade 45 All Out Show, sir?
Man, usually, man, I'm riding around trying to make some money selling insurance, bro.
I'm
just
not
cracking up with your retarded ass.
No, I love it. I love it. That's what I love. I love to hear what y'all do when you're listening to Shade 45, and it's usually getting money or on the way home from getting money. You ready to do this shit?
Yeah, you keep us going, man.
That's my job, is to make your job easier. That's all. That's all it is.
Oh man, and let's get to this photo code pocket pussy.
Man, we got it. Man arrested, accused of throwing a handful of feces at officers. 52 years old. He took two 20 packs and two 8 packs of beer without paying. The cops came, and then that's when. Wow, why you hit white really fast? What's the reason?
Shit, I didn't hear about no 52-year-old dude getting the shit shot out of him in the last couple of weeks. So, brother, throw some feces at a cop. That's a wrap. Shit.
All right.
Anyway, I'm from Texas.
Well, he is also from Texas as well. Texas.
South Galveston somewhere.
PHR, Texas. All right, I'm going to is that your final answer?
That's the final answer.
I'm going to read you I'll read you his name, and you tell me if you think you're right or wrong. Baltazar Mendoza Zarate.
God damn.
yeah.
I was confident in a motherfucker, too. I ain't see no headline.
Man was sad. Wendy's didn't sell cinnamon buns. So he smashed the window in protest. This it's a 19-year-old. He was upset that he didn't have any cinnamon roll buns. So he grabbed a fucking rock and busted out the window.
What type of bullshit is that?
Well,
you're a special type of homo for that shit. Man, boys out here crashing windows for buns, cuz. Damn, that's hard, man.
Well, a passerby was like, "Why did you do that?" And he said, "They don't sell cinnamon buns anymore." They asked his profession. He was listed as a carpenter, and
Shit, that's Jesus' occupation.
And he's from Florida.
I'm gonna go with Florida. That's white.
Once again, is that your final answer?
Final answer. Final answer.
I'll read you his name, and then you tell me if you think you're right or wrong. Dustin Riley Tyrell.
Tyrell threw me off, but other than that, that's a white dude name, like a motherfucker.
Yeah, if it started with Tyrell, you was fucked, but it ended with Tyrell, so you were golden. It started with Dustin. All right. So
Dustin, either way, man. You know, I know some blacks, some white Dustin.
I think it was the Riley that really fucking saved the day for you.
Riley got it. I don't know one black dude named Riley.
If I did, I'd smack him.
If I do, he ain't telling nobody. His name is Riley.
it's our diggy.
CFO, man.
All right, here it is. An Amazon delivery driver stole a Texas couple's dog and then tried to sell it online. Damn,
cuz out there hustling. That's definitely not white.
Okay, you want to hear a little bit more of the story? All right,
CFO,
so he's a
man.
He's a delivery driver. He's out there making deliveries when he sees a dachshund, 2-year-old, and it darted out of his home. So he picked it up, and he was selling on Craigslist for $100.
A hundo?
Yeah.
I think other.
And this was a woman. That did it.
A woman did this shit?
Yep.
What state was this in?
Texas. Weatherford, Texas.
Man, this all close to me too, man. These motherfuckers is out here with the shits. That's up there by the phone. I think that might be black. I'm gonna go with black, final answer.
Once again, I will read you the name, and then you tell me how you did.
It's going to be a Taisha.
Mika Kiana Wade.
What I tell you. I motherfucking tell you, Jude. She didn't even get enough money. That's how I knew it was a black girl.
She didn't know what the dog was worth. Yeah, $100 for a dachshund.
Put some goddamn some tracks on her hair, dog. What the fuck? This is out here crashing for nothing.
I know, like, hey, Chris, do me a favor. Look up. I just want to know how much dachshunds go for. Them bitches are expensive,
way
I think.
Way more than that.
Yeah, more than $100 fucking dollars.
South, them SA love them dachshunds.
Yeah, that was, she did give herself away on that one.
Hundo, man, she out here crashing.
Says right here that breeders can sell them anywhere from $200 to $1,000.
Depending on
the purebred.
Yeah, what the breed is.
They're not friendly, so this had to be a nice one to come running up to her.
Yeah, they, the, yeah.
The fuck she walking around with a dachshund under her shirt, picture that shit.
Yep. Shout out to my homie who's a dachshund got ate by a wolf or a coyote. R.I.P. He's probably listening right now. Shout out to the homie.
R.I.P.
All right, yeah. Little dachshund had heart. Just couldn't fight that coyote. Who the fuck is calling me? All right, here it is. Man jailed after his own dash can filmed him dealing drugs.
Mm-hmm.
He was selling cocaine and heroin out of his car window after they pulled him over in a yellow Ford Focus.
White.
Was it the Ford Focus?
A yellow Ford Focus, cuz. That nigga might as well put a goddamn Target out there, huh?
And he would have been good, man. He's like, that's super low key. You're driving around a Ford Focus. No one's going to think you're selling drugs.
Yeah, but then it's yellow.
Yeah. Yeah, they found, they also found cannabis plants at his home. And then,
Come on.
Yep.
Niggas, we can't even grow vegetables, cuz. Come on. Yeah. That's what that is.
All right, so you won. Now, this is for the people playing at home. Damn. A man convicted of attempted murder catches a ride with juror and escapes during court recess.
Man.
Boy. So, he was convicted of murder. I don't know if the juror knew the man.
Baffled the kid, man.
Yeah, let's see. Yeah,
baffled the fuck out of me.
They said they saw him hop in a Camaro with the juror. I don't know if he was a juror on his case or not. Officials say the murderer fled from the courthouse during recess while the jurors were deliberating.
That shit's crazy. Where was this at?
Oh, and this isn't, well, hold on, let me finish. Once the juror was questioned, the juror admitted to driving the murderer home and said that they did not discuss the case during the drive. This is all I can tell you. If I tell you where it happened, you'll know the answer.
Is it north or south? Can you tell me that?
You already won, so I'm not giving you any. I'm not giving you any.
I can dig that.
So, let's see how you do. If just I'm it's in black. America, and if I tell you where it
I'm
is,
say black. I think that was somewhere in Dade County.
It was in Memphis.
I still got it.
Yup, you're right. Fucking black. Yeah, fucking first 48 like a motherfucker.
Yeah. Shout out to my partners in West Memphis. Them niggas are real killers.
Oh, damn. Madricius Blakes, 32 years old.
Oh,
yep, Madricius.
Come on, Madricius.
Yeah, Madricius Blakes, 32 years old.
About 30 points in Scrabble.
Yep.
The fuck?
That's a bingo. You ain't bullshitting. Yeah, you're right. Damn.
You, man. I just wanted to say that, man. I fucks with you long way, man. The hyena book, hummingbird. Man,
thank
you the truth out here, man.
Appreciate
you,
man.
I got this. You were sway.
Man, thank you. Actually, I think they just told me Sway's going to be out in Los Angeles, so hopefully Sway'll come by the show and kick it with us.
Yeah, man. Y'all made my day easy, bro.
Love it. Love it. All right, man. Congratulations. You fucking won, and I appreciate you listening and subscribing, man. Real talk.
Always, man. Y'all stay up. John, put that shovel motherfucking chin in some pussy, man.
Fine.
Come on, dog. Can you dig it, face-ass nigga?
Can't help yourself.
Uh-huh. Hey, I fucks with you, Joe. I fucks with you.
I appreciate that, man.
Bye. He said, can you dig it? All right, y'all. That was Black, White, or Other. Don't go nowhere. It's an all-out show. Hey, stick around. You got a chance to win tickets to the fucking Cannabis Cup. Me and Bylug and Wish Premier at Penthouse on 8 Mile this Saturday night, 10 o'clock. Don't go nowhere.
It's time for the All Out Show Remix. On Remix Shows, you'll hear memorable guests, crazy topics, game shows, celebrity interviews, and you might even catch a hilarious segment you missed. Keep it here and stay tuned.
Shay 45, you are listening to the All Out Show. I'm in Detroit City. How come? Because we got the Dream Cruise. What's a Dream Cruise? As you know, we're the Motor City. We got Ford. We got Chrysler. We got GM. We put y'all motherfuckers on wheels, all right? And then once a year, everybody comes out with all their classic cars, drives up and down Woodward. It's a beautiful thing. I'm going to check that shit out. And we also got the Cannabis Cup. Now, if you want to win tickets to the Cannabis Cup after party with Bylug and Wish Cannabis Premium Entertainment. That's what I'm down with. That's where the Hyena Strand comes from. And my shit is fucking fire right now. I'm not even fucking bullshit you. We're going to be at the Penthouse on 8 Mile. Penthouse Club on 8 Mile Road. If you're in the Detroit area, you're over 21, you want to come party Saturday night, starts at 10 o'clock. Call up right now, 888-742-3345. If you're not in Michigan, you don't want to do it, fuck it. Stick around for the news. We got John telling you the news. If you're a black person and you're getting tested for doing coke, listen to this shit. It is fucking crazy. We also got some new sex positions. Don't go anywhere. It's an all-out show.
It's time for the All Out Show Remix. On Remix Shows, you'll hear memorable guests, crazy topics, game shows, celebrity interviews, and you might even catch a hilarious segment you missed. Keep it here and stay tuned. And now, it's time for News from the Chin with John Z. Matthews.
Looks like the seashell sex position is a good idea. People are talking about it. It's driving couples wild.
What, I don't even know what that means. What is the seashell?
I've seen it, but...
What's it look like?
So, it looks like to master this, first you need to lie on your back. This is the woman.
The chick lies on her back?
Right. Propped up on your elbows. That's an option, but not required. Okay. Bring your legs as far back as they can go. Ideally, you want them near your ears. And make sure you only go as far as you're comfortable. But mainly, it's sort of like the, let me sort of explain it. It's the missionary with the lady's legs pinned back.
Man, bro, I've been claiming this shit since forever. I'm tired of these motherfuckers biting off my sex moves.
Well, there's a name for it now, the seashell.
No, it's called the Jude stack them legs.
Stack the legs.
You stack the legs, and don't be too flexible.
Oops.
Remember what we say, ladies. You don't want to be like a Barbie doll where you just fucking the legs go all the way back and the pelvis stays the same. You want to stack the legs, tilt the fucking pelvis, and bang that shit out so you're hitting the G-spot. John's never heard of the G-spot, but they got one. And you just hitting that motherfucking G-spot, just grinding in that shit.
And there are two moves when you're in this position. You can
tell me more.
Okay.
All right, tell me more about my own fucking sex move.
Have him ride high, rubbing his pubic bone against your clitoris.
Wow.
Or ride low, directly stimulating the G-spot, the so-called G-spot, with the head of your penis.
The so-called G-spot. So you got the stack the legs version?
Uh-huh.
Where you can do it where you're stacking the legs and you're kind of laying face-to-face. And then you can do it where you're sitting straight up. And then you really push them shits back.
Queen.
So you're almost making like the letter L.
Oh.
You see what I'm saying?
Right.
The one where you stack the legs and you're on top and you're grinding it out. And then the other way is you stack them legs and start fucking. And that really hits that spot. That's when they'll be like, I'm gonna pee. And then you be like, just piss the bed. I don't give a fuck.
I don't think I'll
it's
say
not
that.
Pee. It's, just tell them that. Just be like, piss. Pee then. Pee. Take that shit.
Do
and
it.
It's not pee. It's they just whoosh, splash.
Mm.
And make a mess. And then you be like, yeah, make a mess. Look at you.
Dirty mess.
Yeah, look at that mess. Lick it up.
Clean it up.
Eat it up.
So how often do you break out the stacked legs thing? Is that a standard, like, hey, we're having sex, time to put those legs back by your ears?
Usually, yeah.
Probably
like nine times. Last time I had sex, I was fucking tired, so she just rode me. And that was a fucking motorcycle just drove by on the fucking
sure.
on the sidewalk, if that's what you were wondering what that rumbling was. Last time we had sex, she just rode me. And you can still do that same thing where they're pushing the clit onto you. It's a real game changer, you know what I'm saying? Because they're getting that clitoral stimulation that they like, and they're getting the dick at the same time. So you really feel like you're doing some shit. And then talk shit in their ear.
Insulting them?
Nah. Grind your clit on me or some shit. Yeah, grind that motherfucking pussy on me. Try it, John. Like a chick's riding you.
All right. You filthy whore. No. Wait a minute. All right. Grind. No, hang on a second.
You got this, bro. Don't give up.
Grind. All right, here
Johnny.
We go.
Oh, John, I'm riding you, John.
Grind that pussy. Grind that pussy on me.
Oh, John, I'm riding
grind
you.
Oh. Your pussy's so wet.
Oh, grind up now. Grind up now, John.
All right, here it is. Okay, grind it. Okay. I'm putting your legs back. Back by your ears. Take it.
Oh, man.
No, I don't know. I wouldn't say it. No, what? Let me just close my eyes.
Stiff.
Let me just close my eyes. Okay, I'm having sex.
Okay, close your eyes. All right. You're having sex with a girl.
I'm not looking at Chris.
John.
All right. Grind your pussy. I don't know, man. I'm trying.
I was laughing at you. Somebody right. funny walked by.
Okay,
go ahead.
Fine.
Yeah.
All right, here
go
we
ahead.
Go.
Try it again.
I'm back in the zone. All right,
get in the zone.
Yeah, grind that pussy. There we go. See? That's authentic. That's the deal. That's what it would sound like.
Yeah, grind that pussy.
You make me sound like such a weasel. I mean,
you do sound like a weasel when you say it. I get way nastier than what we're saying on air. I get disgusting. I'm foul as shit.
Ugh.
You're super stiff.
No. I mean, after a couple times of having sex, I can get down to business. It would work.
Oh, John, I'm riding you. I'm riding you, John.
Oh, yeah, you're so wet and grinding. I don't know, man. I'm trying.
Why are you giving
I'm
up?
I'm trying.
Because I'm laughing at you.
You're taking
I'm
me
laughing.
Out of that
why
zone.
Are you giving up?
All right, fine.
Oh, yeah, you're so wet.
Yeah. You're like you hanging on the corner insulting me while I'm fucking
nah,
some
bro,
lady.
You got to tell right. girls what to do. They like that shit.
All right.
Even if they're already doing it, you just tell them what to do.
Yeah.
They want to feel like someone's in charge.
Okay.
You're just giving them compliments, which is cool. But like, you gotta be like, yeah, fucking grind on that shit, push on that shit, and then push them down on you. You know what I mean?
Take that dick. Sure. There you go. All right.
Try again.
Oh man. All right. Get on all fours here now. I don't know. All right. No. All right. Spread those. All right. Spread your cheeks. Spread. I don't know. I don't know. I'm so out of this. I'm trying. I really swear to God, I am.
Man. it's funny, like, I can't have silent sex or else I feel really uncomfortable, and you can't have talking sex or else you get really uncomfortable.
You know, I
isn't that funny?
I don't do a lot of talking.
Isn't that weird for you? What do you just, you're just sitting there?
Yeah, kind of. I think so.
Oh, man.
Well,
no wonder, yeah, fuck.
What do you, I mean, is that normal?
Chris, do you talk shit when you're banging, or
what? It depends on the moment, but yeah, I usually talk, yeah.
Yeah.
You're kidding.
It's kind of awkward when you're just quiet the whole time.
Yeah. Why? You're just sitting there,
Yeah, you're so hot. Look at those tits. Or, I don't know.
Oh, my God.
No, I would never say that. I would never say that.
Then why are you saying it now?
I don't know.
Why are you saying it now, John?
I'm fine.
Why are you fucking your imaginary girl now? Just, oh, look at those tits.
I wouldn't say that. Fucking I would creep. Say those breasts are great. Look at those.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Fucking across the country, you're just making pussies right. Just dry up.
The next time I'm having sex, I'll make a mental note to start talking, and I'll figure out what's going to work.
The girl usually tells you.
Yeah. All right.
Just tell them what to do, even if they're already doing it.
Really?
Yeah, be like, yeah, ride that dick, girl. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, ride that shit. Take that shit.
Huh.
Push right. down.
I got it.
Stay on it, you know?
I honestly, the next time the sex happens, I will make.
I can't wait for you to be. I can't wait for this shit.
I will.
Hey,
I will report back.
Stay on me. Stay on me. Stay on it.
Get on top.
Oh yeah, you got a bus pass to my dick, babe. Oh yeah. All day Metro pass. Ride that dick.
Riding the red line.
cats in LA, no, riding the red line, yeah. Take the blue train to Watts, baby. Yeah, fuck yeah.
Oh, here's a deep tunnel.
We spent way too much time. All right, look, yeah, so there it is. That's a new, they call it the clam position. I think most people that fuck have been doing this position for a minute, and if you haven't, it really... I learned this position because I was uncomfortable with my dick size, and it's just like learning the way I put it. It's just like knowing how to work. Like if you're playing basketball, knowing post moves. You know what I mean? It's all about angles and leverage and shit like that.
Coincidentally, I was watching porn with the so-called seashell not that long ago, but I was searching for what was it called? Pin down and missionary position. So, and you get to watch a whole compilation like that.
It's called pin down a missionary position.
That's what I just oddly enough within the last month I was checking that out.
That's been your new jam.
Well, I mean I've sent you a link if you wanna.
That's cool. I don't know. Yeah. Like I fucking stayed in that fucking just watch Calendar Girls last night. It was at my mom's.
Calendar Girls.
Yeah, it's Calendar Net Girls. It's one of those things where it's like come on inside. Give me your ID. You want to be in the calendar?
Oh.
Take off. Then it's right. Like, suck my dick. Yeah. It's one of those deals. I just like auditions. It's my jam. It's my jam. Give me some more news.
And turns out that guys are getting upset when they're seeing ripped male models, hot guys in advertisements. So it makes men unhappy with their bodies. Much like, of course, women say that happens, but I guess guys are upset too.
Yo, look, it's been like that. Like, chicks have been having to deal with this for a minute, but so within the last, I don't know, 15, 20 years, ever since men's fitness and all that shit got popular, like, they airbrush dudes the same way they airbrush chicks. And that, like, that's not cool, man. That breaks people's brains. When there used to be magazines, I remember going to 7-Eleven and I would look at like fucking what 3-year-olds and 4-year-olds would see, and it'd just be these slutted out fucking chicks, like with these impossible looks to have. And now they're doing it to dudes.
I guess, but when you see sort of a hot guy in a deodorant ad with his shirt off riding a horse, I mean, do you feel bad about yourself?
If I see a hot guy riding a horse in a deodorant ad, do I feel bad about myself?
I mean, are you succumbing to this?
it's not that I feel bad about myself, but I do realize that I don't have a six pack. You know what I mean? I'm like, oh yeah, I don't have a six pack. And it's the same with, like, we were talking about porn. You know what I mean? Like, people are always fucking complaining about, like, ladies feel weird about the way they look. Guys feel weird about their dicks because, like, in porn, all you see are fucking giant penises.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then you look at your dick and you're like, So, like, I think both sexes have these impossible or really hard to live up to views of themselves that they're being shown. Some, like, you know, super ripped dudes, fucking big ass dicks, chicks with no fucking cellulite and all that stuff, tits not drooping at all, like gravity doesn't exist.
I'm not sure what they want us to do. I guess just identify, hey, this could happen to you. But I mean, I don't think the advertising companies are going to change their ways.
Oh, no, they're not going to change their ways. Most advertising is negging, dude. Like, most advertising, especially, like, in cosmetics and shit, they're like, oh, you want to feel pretty. You don't have this, so you don't feel pretty. It's crazy how that shit goes.
Well, I suppose you could strive for it, get a gym membership, and really start.
I don't think, like, some people just ain't built like that. You can work out all you want, and some people are going to be built different. Like, I got a cousin. Like, my cousin, he can do fucking 40 push-ups and, like, do some sprints and shit, and he looks ripped. And I do the exact same thing, and it just doesn't, it looks like I did nothing. It's just the way it goes, man. That's why you got to be fucking, that's why I'm never worried about my dick or none of that shit. You know why? Because it's attached to me.
Nice.
And I got a fucking, I'm a charming motherfucker.
So, but don't those guys that are so obsessed with their appearance and, you know, always working out, don't they seem kind of like douchebags? Or
chicks don't like them for a lot of times. And you know, the chicks that like them are fucking douchey chicks. Yeah. They seek each other out. The chicks that want that guy are usually shallow bitches.
Yep.
That are fucking posing in front of some step and repeat at a fucking bar that, you know what I mean?
It's been my
some
experience.
Fucking, like, Quavo step and repeat in front of some fucking shit bar on Hollywood Boulevard. Step and repeat, for y'all that aren't from Hollywood or anything like that, it's like the fucking, the backdrops with the logos all in front of it that, like, nobody's posted. Like, take pictures in front of for, like, bar openings and shit.
I looked that up once. What the hell? Why do they call it a step and repeat?
Because you step, take a picture,
and
then it's repeated.
Okay. Fairly.
Are you hearing this fucking, the shit going on outside, or is it just
a little bit? It's
all right.
Little flavor.
Just so you guys know, I'm in Detroit, and they're fucking, They're fucking the shit out of the sand right now. I don't know. They got some machine that's just, like, just banging the sand. It's so weird, dude.
Progress.
Yeah. Fucking vibrating the whole fucking building. Sweet. Shout out to the Foundation Studio at the Foundation Hotel. Thanks for letting me do this. I'm not even shitting on y'all. It's not like they fucking decided that they're gonna
tear up the street.
Yeah, fix the street the day I came in.
Now, I didn't know this. I'm sorry, what?
What didn't you know?
The NAACP, they're out there saying now that the drug tests that are done on hair, this is causing black people to falsely test positive for cocaine.
That's crazy, dog. So what's going on with that?
So they are saying that the melanin in the dark hair picks up coke. It can pick up anything in the environment. Smoke, it picks up quickly, whether or not you're using. So, for example, again, this is going to end the NAACP, but I'll look at this deeply in a little bit.
So if there's coke in the air?
Or even, let's say, on a dollar bill, and then you touch your hair, some residue.
It oh.
Could, So the follicle test, and then according to one lady here, this happened, and she took the test a couple days later, and she came up negative. So I guess this is happening.
Wouldn't that be, like, inconclusive in having a retest, though? Like, if it's that small of an amount?
That's what I would argue.
So, yeah, like...
I mean, I think... So if you test positive and you're black, you may want to look into this and say, well, hey, wait a minute. People are saying that...
Hold on one second. There was coke in the air.
Hey, there was, it's worth a shot.
I was here. I was at the club, and someone just blew a whole fucking eight ball in my hair. I didn't snort any of it.
Nope.
Maybe. That's something to... Hey, if you're black, guys, and you got to do a drug test, wash your hands after you touch dollar bills.
More good advice?
I mean, I don't know how many... Like, I don't know how much... There's got to be, like... Chris, will you look up and see how much coke is on money?
It's a lot.
I'm just kind of curious.
Have you ever taken a drug test recently? Oh, not recently, but in the last 20 years.
Have I taken a drug test? Back when I was on probation, I had to piss.
Okay.
But I never did. Like, all the drugs I do, they don't test for.
Says right here that 80% of cash carries cocaine, and that's from CNN.
There you go. But I don't, of that cash, I don't know, like, how much coke is transferable. You know what I mean? Like, if it's enough to transfer from your fingers onto your hair and have it pick up in a test. You know, you right. Catch what I'm throwing at you?
Right.
You know, there might be, like, little trace amounts.
Yeah. But I guess, really, if you test positive and you know you're not out there blowing rails, I mean, it makes sense to go back and have...
Demand a retest? Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, fucking, yeah. Why not? I mean, I had homies do that shit, like, working in the army. And they test, like, they test you for fucking weed or some shit, and it's inconclusive, or it'll false positive, and then you just kind of, like, be like, test me again.
Right.
And wait. And you gotta wait a few weeks, and then you just fucking stay off the drugs and beat the test.
That's good advice.
There you go.
I've got some good news if you want that.
That wasn't the good news?
Well, it's, you know, good building to it.
That's good.
And now, time for good news.
There it is.
Oh, boy.
Hey.
There's this restaurant in Ohio.
Okay.
And they are giving convicts a second chance. And it's called Edwin's Restaurant in Cleveland. It aims to tackle one of the nation's biggest problems. People get out of jail, and then they...
Recidivism.
Yeah, they're screwed.
Yeah, they really gotta fucking... They really gotta fix that shit. Like, I was talking... Like, just... Even if you're a total fucking piece of shit... Let's say you're a total fucking piece of shit, and you are, like, a rapist or something, or you killed somebody, and you go to jail... Like, you come out, we still need to do something with you. You know what I mean? Like, you still have to re-enter society. We can't just keep fucking punishing you. So we have to come up with shit like that. So that's dope that this restaurant's fucking training people.
Yeah,
what are they doing?
It's called Edwin's. It's run by this guy from Detroit, by the way, Brandon Krostowski, and he trains those who've had a run-in with the law in an attempt to give them a better life. He had a run-in back when he was 18 dealing drugs, but the judge cut him a deal, and he put him on probation, and then he went to cooking school, the Culinary Institute of America. Now he's got these restaurants, and he's an accomplished chef.
Hey, look, man. I don't know about these cooking schools, y'all.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, dude. Like, you watch it firsthand. You watch it firsthand, especially in California. You see these motherfuckers. They go and they drop $60,000 to go to the CIA, and then they come to work in the kitchens, and they got Mexican cats that are willing to do the same shit that are getting paid $10 an hour. Like, you're better off just going to the fucking kitchen and learning how to fucking cook, and like starting the dish tank and work your way up.
Right. No, that's true.
I think you want to go to school to be an electrician, go to school to be a fucking plumber, go to school to fucking, like, build houses. That's the shit right there, man. Those are the trades that ex-cons need to go into, where they're not fucking, you can do it yourself. Paint, you know what I mean? Go be a painter. I told you, they fucking got me. Were we talking about this, or was that I got arrested when I was 17, but they tried me as an adult, and I didn't even realize it was a fucking felony or anything. I don't even know if it is a felony, but like 3 months into me having the job at Sirius, like fucking HR calls me in, and I'm like talking to the vice president in HR, and they're like, "You got something to tell us?"
What?
Yeah, I was like, "What are you fucking?" No. And they're like, "You were arrested. You were for this, that, and the third." And I was like, "Yeah." I was like, "That was a long time ago." They told me that wasn't. They told me it was a misdemeanor. Turns out it wasn't. I was fucking court appointed. He's like, it's a misdemeanor. Just plead guilty. Fucking dogging me to this day. Yeah, but anytime you're coming out of jail and you're worried about motherfuckers not hiring you, go get trained in some shit where you can be your own boss. And I'm telling you, you get paid more than most of these other motherfuckers anyway. Like, I have we've had plumbers come into the fucking house, and they charge like a fucking ton of money. Electricians, they charge you like a couple racks to fucking do shit. And it's hard to be replaced.
Yeah.
Also, a truck driver, shout out to truckers and shit. Like, you can get your own license. Start driving. There's ways out there. You don't have to go back to jail. But you need to know that shit.
And if you're in Cleveland, go check out Edwin's. He'll take care of you.
Edwin will take care of you. And he'll probably point you in the right direction.
Yeah, Edwin's restaurant in Cleveland.
Brandon. My homegirl was talking to me about that. Like, she was working with convicts and, like, teaching them how to read. And this dude ran the yard. Like, this guy, like, ran the motherfucking yard. And they was letting him out of jail. And she wasn't allowed to come. She wasn't allowed to leave because they was letting him out at the same time. So she had to, like, wait for this motherfucker to leave. And she's watching him. And he just, like, they let him out the gates. There's no one there to pick his ass up. And here's this, like, big, tough guy. And he's just sitting there holding a little paper bag, like, and he doesn't know what to do, man. It's fucking heartbreaking, you know?
Oh, sure.
It's fucking, not oh, sure, motherfucker. No, it's like, it's fucking heartbreaking, dude. Like, this guy doesn't know what the fuck to do. He's been institutionalized, and now he's like, oh, you're off on your own. And here's a paper bag, and you don't even got, like, and the guards took all your shit, and you don't even have any fucking thing to start over with. Good luck. Don't fuck up again. Whatever you do, don't fucking fall back into your old behavior. Don't sell dope. You know what I mean? It's like, it's tough. So, hats off to this fucking dude in Cleveland.
Brandon Krastowski.
Oh, sure.
Well, right. It's terrible. Never mind.
That's how you sound like when you're in a pussy. No one, you ain't got no passion, John. You ain't got no motherfucking passion.
I've got heart. Ask anybody. Got
you ain't got no passion. Listen to him when he says it. Even when he says it.
People know I have heart.
I've got heart. Listen to me. Like, no one believes you, dude. You got no passion, bro.
I'm just brimming with passion.
You the Tin Man.
No. Nope.
Heartless motherfucker, bro. You the Tin Man and the motherfucking Scarecrow. No brain.
Oh.
And the Lion. No courage. You all three of them motherfuckers.
I've got lots of courage. I can summon a level of menace that keeps me safe on the streets.
And you got motherfucking the Wicked Witch of the East chin. You the whole goddamn Wizard of Oz except for Dorothy. That's the news.
It's time for the All Out Show Remix. On Remix Shows, you'll hear memorable guests, crazy topics, game shows, celebrity interviews,
And you might even catch a hilarious segment you missed. Keep it here and stay tuned.
J45, that was the show. I want to thank Foundation Studios at Foundation Hotel. Shout out to Jen. Shout out to Bob. Shout out to Peter. Everybody's treating me real nice over here. Really appreciate y'all. Lucien Greaves was the cat that has the Hail Satan documentary that we spoke to. That was like fucking smart talk and shit. Not too bad. Chris on the boards. Alex runs things. Associate producer Keenan handling. Andy also handles all of the fucking, all of our social. And John Matthews, producer and news. You can find out any information on me at onemorejude.com. onemorejude.com will also get you. You can grab yourself some All Out Show gear. Fucking fire, son. Get the old English one. It's dope. All right, man. We out. Talk to you tomorrow.